Welcome to the 50th high school reunion for the John L. Miller Great Neck North Senior High School. We have well over 100 classmates who are here with us at the Douglaston Manor. Well, it was actually 50 years ago today, but the song was written when we were in eighth grade in 1967. Today we celebrate our graduation from high school 50 years ago in 1972. We brought together over 100 classmates to Douglaston Manor in Douglaston, New York, to celebrate with us. But it's not just about high school. It's about growing up in Great Neck. All the people, events, and schools that we went to along the way that brought us to where we are today. Arundel, JFK, some of us went to Baker Hill, Saddle Rock, and of course, the junior high school, and graduating our high school from 1969 to 1972. And then there was high school. The years 1969 through 1972 were incredible years.
'69 was a year that changed the world. Richard Nixon was sworn in. Golda Meir becomes Prime Minister of Israel. Charles became Prince of Wales, starting his incredibly long wait to become King of England. And he is still waiting. In technology, Dr. Denton Cooley implants the first artificial heart. The first automated teller machine goes into service on Long Island. The internet comes to life.
Typed the L, and he said he got the L, and his system took it, sent it back to me to print on my terminal, and my terminal printed the L. And I said, great, I got the L back. And I typed the O, and same thing. And then I typed the G, and he said, wait a minute, my system crashed.
The Boeing 747 takes to the air, ushering in a new world of inexpensive mass market travel. Apollo 11 takes off from the Kennedy Space Center.
This is Houston. All your systems are looking good. Going around the corner, we'll see you on the other side. Over.
For mankind's first attempt to land on the moon.
Houston, Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
Splashing down 8 days later after.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
In the world of sports, Willie Mays becomes the first Major League Baseball player since Babe Ruth to achieve 600 career home runs.
First, here's a pitch to Willie.
Swung on, hit deep to left. That one is way back. Pull it to try number 600 for Willie Mays.
The 2-1 pitch.
The amazing New York Mets beat the Baltimore Orioles to win the World Series. New York Jets, 1,000-1 underdogs, upset another Baltimore team, the Colts, to win Super Bowl. The Stonewall Riots in New York City's Greenwich Village marked the start of the modern gay rights movement and the first gay pride parade 1 year later. The poorly planned and out-of-control Woodstock Music Festival, actually held in Bethel, New York, gathers together 400,000 young adults for 3 days of peace, love, and rock and roll. Remember, bookstores, right? On TV, Sesame Street. And Scooby-Doo.
Scooby-Dooby-Doo!
Make their first appearances. The Beatles give a final concert on the roof of their Apple Records office building and release the album Abbey Road, with the iconic and much copied photo of the four band members crossing the street at Abbey Road.
The dawn of a new decade
brings us to the year 1970. The year itself was pretty low-key, but remnants of the 1960s still persisted. During this year, people who were protesting the war and civil rights began to look for other ways to seek change, so some of their attention shifted to the environment. With the invasion of Cambodia, the U.S. was still deeply involved in the Vietnam War, but were looking for ways to expand, equip, and train South Vietnamese forces so we could draw down U.S. combat troops. On January 25th, the movie MASH, directed by Robert Altman, was released. It starred Donald Sutherland and Elliot Gould, and was a massive success, giving birth to the long-running TV show of the same name years later. The year 1971 was a turning point for the United States on many fronts. Not only was the morale of U.S. troops in the Vietnam War very low, but anti-war sentiment was ramped up when the largest ever anti-war demonstration happened in Washington, D.C. Technology was also evolving, with the introduction of the microprocessor, and the very first email was also sent this year. Change also came to the Constitution, with ratification of the 26th Amendment, giving younger Americans the right to vote. 1971 was a great year for music, too, with some of the best-loved albums of all time being released. 1972 was an interesting year. So much was going on politically with the drawdown in Vietnam, Watergate, and rising security threats with airline hijackings that many of the other events sometimes get forgotten. The year brought us the start of the video game era, epic new movies, and a record-breaking performance at the Munich Olympics by a U.S. swimmer. There was a lot going on, to say the least, which is what makes 1972 such a memorable year.
Some of the major news events in 1972 included the 11 Israeli athletes who were murdered by Arab gunmen at the Munich Olympics, and five White House operatives who were arrested for burglarizing the offices of the Democratic National Committee, which is the start of the Watergate scandal. The United States and Soviet Union signed the Anti-Ballistic Missile Treaty, and NASA's space shuttle program was officially launched. The miners' strike in the United Kingdom, and 16 survivors from the plane crash survive and are rescued after practicing cannibalism. Bloody Friday, 22 bombs explode in Belfast, Ireland, and the IRA bomb explodes at the 16th Parachute Brigade headquarters at Aldershot. Anti-war demonstrations drew over 100,000 demonstrators in U.S. cities, and the Dow Jones closed above 1,000 for the first time in history. Our generation will never come back. We walked to school, did our homework to get out as soon as possible to play in the street. And we spent all of our free time in the streets playing with friends. We played hide and seek and stickball, collected baseball cards. We had vinyl albums that we played on our record players, board games and card games on rainy days. And our TVs went off at midnight after playing the national anthem. Our parents were always there. And we laughed under our covers so our parents didn't know we were still awake. We are a generation that will never return, no matter how hard we try. Growing up when we did, it was the best of times. Do you remember what we watched on TV? Samantha from Bewitched, The Odd Couple, Brady Bunch, Partridge Family, and Love American Style. Those were the days of early sitcoms. There were a few blockbuster movies in 1972. The Godfather and Poseidon Adventure, Deliverance. I mean, there was a lot to watch at the Playhouse and Squire movie theaters. Now, this is a class of overachievers. We had 36 doctors, 24 lawyers, 24 teachers and professors. Many, many, many books were authored by our classmates. We have a couple of yoga instructors, a boat captain, an acupuncturist, an architect, a federal judge, numerous real estate professionals, many business owners, computer consultants, and investors. 25% of us are retired, and many more, of course, are semi-retired. Lots of firefighters and policemen, and a future congressman. There are 476 graduates. We have spread out all over the place. We're in 32 states, 9 countries. I haven't found 79 of them, and unfortunately, 57 are deceased. Still, a majority are in New York, and I guess there's a whole crew in California and Florida. Some of them are in Belize and Brazil and Germany and Mexico, but many of them come to celebrate with us at our reunion. Of course, we have Beanie, who was nominated to the United States Court of Appeals for the Sixth Circuit by President George W. Bush. Don't tell her we called her Beanie, because I don't think she goes by the Honorable Beanie White anymore. And of course, we have Kenneth Cole, the world famous clothing designer, who among us hasn't bought a pair of shoes, a wallet, some luggage or something from Kenneth Cole Reaction. He's a tremendous supporter of charities such as AIDS Life and the Candies Foundation, Human Rights Campaign, Make-A-Wish Foundation, and Sundance Institute. But to us, he'll always be Kenny, not Kenneth.
Right now, I'm in France with my family, but normally you can find me in the Haight-Ashbury section of San Francisco, where I have lived since 1979. I'm a retired law professor and dean, UC Hastings, where I taught and wrote about social justice movements and our authentic racial legal history. I married my high school sweetheart. Yes, he was a Southerner. And we just celebrated 48 years. Yikes. We raised two wonderful daughters, one of whom also lives in the San Francisco Bay Area and is a research sociologist. The other lives in Brooklyn and directs a youth theater company in New York City. My new joy is being a nana to a 14-month-old granddaughter. I like to hike, travel, dance, zumba, and salsa, host and visit with friends and family, and spend weekends at our country home. I have had a wonderful 50 years.
Gary Klein's wife, Marcy, is Vice President of Prevention for the Colorectal Cancer Alliance, who recently held a fundraiser in Norwalk, Connecticut, that raised over $1 million for colon cancer prevention. Hootie and the Blowfish performed at the dinner, with Dylan Dreyer and Craig Melvin of the Today Show hosted. Back in high school, we remember our sports teams. Many of us were members of the BAA, Boys Athletic Association, the prestigious organization. We had our football team with Coach Casey and Coach Turner and Coach Burden. And we had our basketball team with Henry Miklas and Kenny Hankinson and Billy O. And of course, our soccer team, who was extremely successful. Let's not forget our girls' sports teams, their basketball team and gymnastics team and their Girls Athletic Association. And of course, the cheerleaders and the Kilties. Susie Feldman lives in New York City, an attorney and primarily in family law, and has published over 60 articles. Lois Friedman is also an attorney and lives in New York City. She's a media executive and corporate lawyer, adjunct professor at the University of Pennsylvania Law School, has two children, granddaughter, and active in public organizations in New York City. Danny Frank shows us his children and grandchildren and his fabulous bear collection.
I have been living in the Bay Area since 1976. I am married to Jim Weil and have two children, Mike, 1986, Josh, 1986, two grandchildren, Hannah, 2018, Ben, 2020. I retired from AT&T as a computer analyst in 2009. I then wrote educational mobile apps until 2019. I hike every day. I volunteer a lot for political and social justice. I also do some community work. Love living in California. Sorry to miss the 50th reunion. Hello to everyone.
And who doesn't remember the fabulous productions put on by our very talented theater group, Guys and Dolls, and the night the rope spent in jail?
Since Great Neck North, I have worked in journalism as well as in public relations. Lived in Los Angeles for nearly 10 years. Co-authored 5 books, the most recent, Inflation, What It Is, Why It's Bad, and How to Fix It. Co-authored with Stephen Forbes and Nathan Lewis, published earlier this year. Wrote and co-produced an award-winning public television documentary, In Money We Trust. On the personal side, many adventures and life lessons, but no kids. Hi all, sorry I'm unable to come to the reunion. Hope it's a great time. I retired from 40 plus years of practicing law a couple of years ago to serve on several boards and to spend more time with my 5 granddaughters and my husband. Feeling lucky and very grateful for where the last 50 years has brought me. All the best.
Hello, my fellow high school classmates of Great Neck North 1972. Plus 50 freaking years. This is Michael Fishback, and I'm very sorry I couldn't be with you. I'm sitting here at my home in Cielo, North Carolina, in the mountains of Western North Carolina near Asheville. Okay, my life in a nutshell. We finished high school in 72. Pretty soon afterwards, I spent 10 years playing on the Men's International Tennis Tour, where I became one of the top 50 players in the world, playing 7 U.S. Opens and every other major tournament that any of you have heard of. Maybe some of you saw me play at the Open. It was great. Wouldn't change it for anything. But when it was over, I wanted to get out of tennis. So I moved up to Vermont and I started a guided hiking business called Vermont Hiking Holidays. That led me to do trips all over the U.S., the Caribbean, Canada, Hawaii, etc. And I ended up meeting some whale researchers in the St. Lawrence River of Quebec and getting involved in whale research and protection. For the last 30 years, I've been studying large whales, primarily the blue whale, the biggest animal on our planet. And 10 years ago, I started a nonprofit called the Great Whale Conservancy. If you want to hear more about us, talk to Kenny Hankinson or Jan Passoff, who have both come seen blue whales with me in my field station in Baja, California, where I've worked the last 28 years in a row. Any of you can come see the biggest animals on the planet with us every February and March. We are now dedicated to helping these animals mostly survive from the unintentional deaths from getting struck by large transiting ships. So we are in fact now moving ships for the safety of whales all over the world. Oh God, it's a long story, but you don't have a lot of time because there's a lot of other people that need to speak at this reunion. So very quickly, we are now raising money to grow our team and stop ship strikes all over the world. Help the whale population grow, which helps the oceans to be more vibrant and actually helps us in our fight against climate change. Now to my family. I got hooked up and married to my wife, Heather, almost 29 years ago. We have 3 children, Sather, Delphi, and Galen. Our youngest, Galen, is just started his senior year in high school. So yes, I had my last child at an advanced age. He is 17. As you know, my age, I won't have to tell you, we're all pretty much the same age. Again, we live in the mountains of Western North Carolina very happily on 7 acres. We have huge gardens, lots of fruit trees, a large stream that we can even swim in, and views of the loftiest mountains in the entire eastern part of North America. And yes, those mountains are in North Carolina, with Mount Mitchell right up above our house being the biggest peak of them all. I wish you all the best. I hope you have a great reunion. I'm sorry I can't be there. I will be in Europe trying to raise funds for our very important nonprofit work. Have a great reunion. Love to you all, and I hope to see some of you, a few of you, here and there. Take care. Lots of love. Yours sincerely, Michael Fishback, your classmate.
Hi, it's Dan Raviv. I'm sorry I can't be there. Great Neck is such a great place. I don't know, it was a launching pad. Didn't we all love being next to New York City? And for my parents, by the way, they came from Israel. I happen to be in Israel as I'm recording this. You know, Great Neck represented success, which I hope it is meant for all of you. You know, keep your optimistic outlook. We are just traveling like hell since I retired from radio and TV about 2.5 years ago. Just travel, travel as long as we can, as long as you're healthy enough and be upbeat. I hope you have a great time at the reunion and my very best to all of you. Sorry I can't be there.
Our future Congressman, Robert Zimmerman.
How to sum up the past 50 years. I married the love of my life in 1976. We divorced in 1993 and remarried in 2014. We have two sons. Our youngest son has nonverbal autism, and while he is a sweet, smart, wonderful person, autism took its toll on our family. Autism also brought us back together 21 years later, older, wiser, and more in love than ever. During the 21 years, I worked as a South Florida regional director, raising funds for autism research and advocating for families and their children with disabilities, along with raising my boys. Today, our son is living a full life in a group home in Florida near where we live. Our oldest son is living in South Carolina and is married and has triplets, two girls and a boy who are 13 years old. We are retired and enjoying life as parents and grandparents. Wow, still can't believe it's been 50 years since Great Neck North 72 graduation. So happy to report good health, loving our retired Colorado lifestyle and still active in golf, mountain activities, and community service. Love to travel, visit with family in New York and beyond, and friends made during our many addresses over the past 30 years. Excited to see all our classmates and remember those who are gone.
Hi from Dallas. I'm Wendy Schlessel-Harpum. I am terribly disappointed I can't attend in person due to illness. I even bought a magic wand on Amazon, hoping it could either cure me or beam me instantly to Great Neck. Well, the wand could do neither. My purchase wasn't a total loss. My grandkids think it's cool. When I think back to my years at Great Neck North, along with my friendships, playing in the orchestra, and competing on the gymnastics team and the mathletes team were highlights of my high school experience. There were many sides of Great Neck North Life that I was not part of and marveled over as a student there, such as those classmates discussing Star Trek episodes and the popular crowd in football and cheerleading. The main reasons I wished to attend the reunion was to reconnect with old friends and to tell many of you how much I admired you while I was in high school. Since graduation, my life has been charmed in good and not so good ways. Since I was a teen, my dream was to become a primary care physician, and my romantic side hoped to have a loving family. When I turned 36 years old, I was living my dream, happily married, three healthy, cute children under six, a busy solo practice of medicine. Weeks later, I wanted a magic wand because I'd developed cancer. For the next 17 years, I was in and out of treatment. After my second recurrence, I participated in a clinical trial. The treatment worked for me. It wasn't magic. It felt like a miracle. And despite my recent diagnosis of aplastic anemia, I am hopeful of still more charmed years. Every day, I have felt grateful to have the means and the access to top medical care. And I really hope our country moves toward making such access possible for all Americans. As for my career, illness forced me to retire at 38 years old. I then found a new and equal passion as a medical writer and a patient advocate. All these decades, I've enjoyed opportunities I might not have had otherwise, such as traveling around the world, working with inspiring, talented, dedicated caregivers and researchers, and helping to shape patient support programs across America. My life has felt charmed in ways having nothing to do with health or work. Against the odds, I got to raise my three young children, none of whom, by the way, were ever impressed with any of my work, except for when I was on Oprah. My husband and I will celebrate our 43rd anniversary this year. My three children settled in Dallas and now have their own families. My six grandchildren all live within 2 miles of me. I'm also my 97-year-old mother's caregiver. And I'm mentioning that because many of you had my mother as your guidance counselor, Naomi Schlessel. To be honest, her memory now is failing, but she still remembers fondly counseling students at Great Neck North, and she asked me to send you her best wishes. Several other classmates also wanted to attend but couldn't due to health challenges. So thank you, John and Lisa and Amy and all the other folks who worked hard to pull this reunion together and gave us this way to participate virtually. Across the miles, I am with you today in spirit and eagerly look forward to the videos and the pictures. I would love to hear from you by email. Wishing you all a magical weekend together. Life is good.
David Kleinberg is one of the most respected and celebrated names in interior design. He's a member of the Interior Design Magazine Hall of Fame and has been honored with the Albert Hadley Lifetime Achievement Award by the New York School of Interior Design. He also supports significant charities.
It saddens me that I won't be able to attend the reunion, but I will be there in spirit. I saw the list of attendees, and there are so many friends I'd love to see. An update on me. I retired after years of working as a certified latent print examiner in a crime laboratory in San Diego County, identifying hundreds of criminals responsible for burglaries, rapes, and homicides. After retiring and trained by the FBI, I went on to work as a forensic artist for law enforcement agencies and universities in San Diego County. Here I help to draw the faces of suspects from victims and witnesses' descriptions as well as the age progressions for missing people. Both fields were extremely rewarding and I enjoyed them immensely. Over the past 2.5 years, I've been learning how to paint in oils and take weekly portrait painting class. My daughter lives happily in Arizona and is employed as an in-house counselor for a bank. I look back on my years at Great Neck North with incredibly fond memories. May you all have a blast and enjoy every moment together. Wish I was there.
Ira Rickless is a very successful entrepreneur and investor, president of Sutherland Capital Management, and a private investment fund, and CEO of a monitoring company called COPS Monitoring, which is one of the largest security monitoring companies in the world. Ira is very charitable. Recently, an article was written about him entitled, Ira Rickless Gives Early and Often, and he dedicates his time to various charities on the boards he sits on.
I moved to California in 1976 after college and never looked back, but I'll always be a New Yorker at heart. I lived in Big Sur for a short time. I'm also still a hippie at heart. And then in Carmel, where I mostly worked in restaurants. In 2001, I moved to Napa Valley. I love it there no matter the season, and I wish I moved here 20 years earlier. Since 2004, I've worked as a tour and event planner, creating customized in itineraries and extraordinary experiences for visitors to the wine country and to the San Francisco Bay Area. It can be stressful at times. I'm grateful to have work that allows me to live in this beautiful place. I'm still footloose and fancy free and have no kids that I know of. I truly regret not being able to attend the reunion and send love to all.
The way.
what can I say about Sweet 16? Lisa, Lynn, Pam, Jackie, and Beanie. Amy Renner moved to San Francisco right after college, and she's still there. She met Louise Kallenbaum in 1986, and they've been happily together ever since. They were one of 3,000-plus gay couples to get married at City Hall in 2004, whose marriages were annulled. But 10 years later, they returned to City Hall after the Supreme Court decision, and now it's official. Anita Ginsburg is still her best friend. They celebrated their 30th birthdays together at the top of Mount Tam, and they've celebrated most together since then. She was editor-in-chief of Women's Sports Magazine that was founded by Billie Jean King from 1980 to 1984. And after years as a journalist and magazine editor, she became a literary agent representing numerous New York Times best-selling authors, including Jimmy Buffett, Rick Hansen, Tom Littlehead, Lichtenhead, Tag LuPone, Amy Krauss Rosenthal, Jacqueline Winspear, and Herman Wolk. A few years ago, she finished 28th out of more than 1,200 women in the World Series of Poker Ladies event. And she recently bought a one-story house in beautiful Tiburon neighborhood with a spectacular willow tree in the backyard. She's still working. She's on the board of the Amy Krauss Rosenthal Foundation, represented the amazing Amy until her death 5 years ago. Then she picked up tennis again about 11 years ago, and now the sport brings her lots of joy. In 2015, her 18 and over team won the USTA National Championships. And she's the only woman, or maybe the only woman, from the Great Neck North graduating class who has never colored her hair.
The morning class of 72, this is the day the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. I came to my happy place, which is the beach, at sunrise to say hello and greetings. Let me see if I can get you some of the sunrise. It's beautiful today. I won't know until I get home whether I captured it or not. So I just wanted to say hello and blessings. Main reason I'm not there, one of the reasons I'm not there, my dad will be 100 on September 18th. I did not want to go anywhere where I had to fly. I just don't want to miss any of my precious moments that I have with him while he's still here on earth, before he transitions home to heaven. And, oh my goodness, so much has happened, but the main thing that really has been life-changing, life-altering to me is that 19 years ago, the Lord revealed himself to me and I offered myself to him, surrendered to him as Lord and Savior. He's guided me, directed me, filled me with joy unspeakable, opened up doors for me that can't even be imagined. Great career, great life, very, very filled with his joy, his peace, his love. So I bless you all, I love you, and look forward to seeing you when we transition to heaven. God bless you. I'm going to see if I can get some of the sunrise. Ooh. Enjoy the weekend.
Here are pictures of my family, me, Andrew, Claire, Leah, and baby Luca. Have a wonderful reunion. Give my best to all. Hopefully we can meet at the 60th. I live in Canada after returning from Berlin. I am retired, but still do editing for a Buddhist organization and care for my one-year-old grandson in Toronto. Life has been very kind to me, and I am quite grateful. I hope that you are all doing well. I think about my great neck years often with both pleasure and pain all at once.
Can you believe it's 50 years since we graduated from high school in 1972? I don't know about all of you, but I feel pretty much the same, even though it's been a great long path. I'm Judy Jablon, and it's great to be here to celebrate with all of you. After graduating from college, I pursued my master's degree at the Bank Street College of Education in New York City and really learned what it means to be a learner. But life happens, and the love of my life, Andrew Mishkin, got sick with a diagnosis of cancer my first week of being a head teacher. And as he finished his life, he gave me this gift about never giving up on possibilities. And so I feel like the next 40 years was a quest to see what I could figure out about being an educator. In starting Leading for Children, I founded a groundbreaking humanity-centered approach to early childhood education that brings together all the adults in the child's life to live the wisdom and come up with solutions that ensure children's success now and in the future. We bring the adults within a community together across all roles and create safe and brave spaces so they can learn with and from each other. They strengthen leadership skills. They figure out how to solve the problems that their community has. And we implement those solutions so that children succeed. Over the course of my 40 years in early childhood, I have learned that stronger adults equals stronger children equals stronger communities. Our work in Alabama has predominantly been at the state level, but one community in particular, Jefferson County, a large geographical area where Birmingham is, reached out to us and said, "We have families who need access to family resources, family court, teen homeless shelter, child care resource and referral agency, the YWCA, the local Head Start program, to see how they can create a more seamless, overarching resource program." Before Andrew died, he asked me to make him a promise, and that promise was to ensure that I would never give up on possibilities. Let's have the class of 1972 bring Andrew's wish of possibilities to Jefferson County so that all children in Jefferson County have what they need to be successful in their future.
I know the coaches were a big part of my high school experience. Coach Casey, the football coach, and Turkey Tommy Turner, and Ed Slater, and Mario LaCorre, and Greeny, Willie P, and Coach Ring. And of course, Denny Burton, who I ran into years later, and was Sue Bird's stepfather. Elizabeth Zerlin was a clinical nurse specialist, online educator, and author of four books. She's studying at Le Cordon Bleu in Paris, as well as being involved with ballet and music, and shows us a picture of her beautiful family.
So sorry I won't be there as planned. I'm in the midst of moving from Atlanta to Florida.
Here's a great picture of the girls in our class. Chuck and Jane Maller with their beautiful family. Some great pictures of our reunions past. I think these are from our 50th birthday party. How about this picture of Patty, Mitzi, and Debbie, and the rest of us at a past reunion? Lila Bender is a psychiatrist, married and living in Great Neck, with her son, who's 34, and daughter, 28, and two grandchildren, ages 1 and 4. Does anybody have a recording of this band with Andrew Mishkin and Charles Putterman and Mark Hertzberg and Scott Kernet? By the way, look at the picture of Lyndon Johnson in the back. And that giant Marlin, which is pretty cool. and Andy Barnett, who would have loved to have been here except for COVID concerns, is a world-renowned plastic surgeon who's living in San Francisco with his wife and two children, painting, sculpting, playing with computers, and cross-country running, sailing, and skiing.
For the last 50 years, I have stayed close to home, settling in on Manhattan's Upper West Side with my husband of 33 years, David, my 29-year-old daughter, Shayna, now married, and a pediatric resident at the Children's Hospital of Montefiore. My 27-year-old son, Jonah, a World War II maven, now working at the Pearl Harbor Aviation Museum in Honolulu in the Education Department. I am a professor of pediatrics in emergency medicine at Columbia and an attending in the emergency department at the Morgan Stanley Children's Hospital in Washington Heights, Manhattan. Well into my 60s, I took up running, crazy, and now have run 3 New York City marathons and many halves, with and without my daughter by my side. Sorry to be missing this wonderful reunion, but I am in Hawaii with family visiting my son, a long-awaited trip, thinking of all of you and wishing I was sharing this adventure with you.
Joan Malman looks like she has a wonderful life, married since 1981 and living in the beautiful Northwest, keeping very busy hiking, snowshoeing, beachcombing, and golfing.
Says she want parties, so can we make these flames go higher? Talking about hey now, hey now, hey now, hey now. I go, ane. Chucking more fina, anane. Chucking more fina, ane. Start my truck, let's all jump in. Here we go together. Nice cool breeze and big palm trees. I tell you, life don't get no better. Talking about hey now,
hey now,
hey now,
hey now.
I go, ane. Chucking more fina, anane. Chucking more fina, ane.
Okay, your mama ngwele. Step on the dancing floor. Hips be winding, DJ rewinding. Take it to the island way. Okay, your baby mama. Put on your
hey, yo, big wave. Tell them I come. Small time alongside JW.
My bestie and your bestie sit down by the fire. Your bestie says she want parties, so can we make these flames go higher? Talking about hey now,
hey now,
hey now,
hey now.
I go, ane. Chucking more fina, anane. Chucking more fina, ane.
Friendship transcends death. Memories made will never be forgotten and created a lasting impression on those they left behind. Everyone became a better person for having such a wonderful friend. I am better for knowing you. Better for loving you, better for having met you. May you be as blessed in the next life, my friend, as I was in this one by knowing you. A lot has happened in the last 50 years. High school diploma doesn't get you as far anymore, and working no longer means heading to the office. People are connected 24/7, and wearing a suit to the office is optional. Talking on the phone has been replaced by texting, and paper books are replaced by digital versions. Of course, milkmen are out of jobs, and taking selfies is a normal hobby. Fewer people smoke, and no one smokes indoors. Parenting is an entirely new ballgame, and we have an enormous amount of knowledge at our fingertips. Hey Google, or hey Siri, or hey Alexa. Where's the fax machine? Cars are bigger than ever. Everybody's driving an SUV, and they even can drive themselves. And of course, security concerns have been very heightened exponentially. And marriage isn't as big a priority as it once was. And Fortunately, we're living longer. But the real question, what will the next 50 years be like?